Welcome back to the Lost Car Keys channel. Today, we'll be showing you how to lose your car keys. To the Modern Brew Life channel. So today, making a beer, not a mead. Give me all your beer. Hops and everything. No. Maybe just hops. So today we're doing a coconut smoked porter.
Buddy Boy's got new ink and it's healing.
Yeah.
It's good stuff.
So if you want to, do you want to read it?
Sure. Yeah. Coconut smoked porter. We've done a smoked porter before and learned that you don't necessarily want to just double all your specialty grains to boost everything up. That was back in our early experiences. And
yeah,
you ever taste liquid smoke? Well, ours had alcohol.
Yeah, pretty much.
Alrighty. So ingredients for this time, starting with, 9 pounds American 2-row, 1 pound of special B, 1/2 pound of flaked oats, 8 ounces of crystal malt, and what is that? That's 40.
Yeah,
40 degrees.
40-0.
Mm-hmm.
40 level bomb.
1 pound of chocolate malt, 12 ounces of Munich. Hop time. We're going to do, we don't want to be too bitter, so we're going to start with 2 ounces of Willamette, 30 minutes into the boil. And another 2 ounces of Cascade right in the last 10 minutes. To make it nice and boozy, we're gonna use the A10 Darkness yeast.
And then for specials, we got, so we're gonna wait a week for it to ferment, and then add 1 pound of grated organic coconut that I'm going to go and smoke it.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, not me personally, but you know, in a smoker.
If you're gonna smoke, smoke coconut,
mm-hmm,
or fish,
yeah, or brisket or tri-tip,
or weed,
yeah, or weed, whatever comes first.
California, man.
Yeah. And then we're mashing in at 149, and so it's going to be an awesome brew day. We got beer, sunny day in the middle of December in San Diego, and he's got some beer too.
I know, we need this. It's hot in the sun today.
Yeah, it's like about...
Sorry, Northwest.
Yes.
Sorry.
65, 70 right now.
Northeast, Midwest, everyone but us.
Yeah.
Cheers to your pains.
Yeah, cheers to that. Middle of December, let's go. Alright, so we're about to mash it in right now.
Mash it in!
All the good grain.
Come get a look at this hot stuff. Excuse me, my grain is down here. Oh, baby.
Alright, so let's mash in all the goodness.
Oh yeah, we got a little bit of black, a little bit of brown, a little bit of white. Oat lives matter. Is that Quaker lives?
Quaker oats?
Oh, that smell. Well, bro, when this video's over, we should do a line of grain dust.
So we come here for folks. All the grain porn. Oh.
We stirs as the grains, hobbits.
Gotta make sure you stir it all correctly in.
Break up any dirt clods.
Oat clods.
Oh, the water's it's just getting darker by the second.
Woo.
COVID!
Let me just die real quick. Alright, so a little update on our grain bill. was a little bit, 5 ounces of Skagit Valley,
peated
malt. Because apparently I'm an idiot and forgot the Rausch malt that we're supposed to use.
Yeah, he just earned the new nickname, Rausch Boy. Rauschy Pete. But, good news, mashing at 149 on the dot, baby.
It's off.
Yeah, whatever. They can't, whatever. They don't
yeah. know. Yeah, so we mashing at 149. Yeah, we're gonna wait an hour. And we're also gonna go get some food.
So, burrito time!
So check back with you guys in an hour, which is really like 2 seconds in YouTube time. Later.
1 hour later.
Alright, and we're back. So, we just finished mashing out. An hour later. And a different beer. Four Corners Brewery, check them out. And so right now we're heating up some sparge water, about a gallon.
Spargy!
And, gonna take out the grain and sparge, or do batch sparge, so stay tuned. So, we've reached that point. We're at a boil right now. So, 1 second. So once we get 30 minutes into the boil, we're going to be adding 2 ounces of Willamette hops, and then the last 10 minutes of the boil, we're going to be adding 2 ounces of Cascade. And then we'll be cooling down, and pitching, pouring it into a fermenter and pitching yeast and making some delicious beer. Not this type of beer, but stout. Since it is winter, even though, you know, it's San Diego, even though it's like 70 degrees and sunny here in San Diego.
Yo, bro, we just got done surfing, bro.
Oh, yeah, bro. Doesn't look like it, but it is winter here, so, continue with the brew day. My dad fixed it. That probably didn't help. Just yeah. Smacking it on the ground.
Cut. Alright, so we're back from camp, and the Scoutmasters didn't touch us too bad.
Back from camp. We're going to go to camp.
They, lots of beer.
Did you go to camp
but beer? We didn't drink any of it, did we?
We went to a camp craft beer. That's what it was.
Craft camp, yeah.
Oh, craft camp.
Isn't that right?
Except we didn't use any glitter. No glitter involved.
No glitter. Only the Scoutmasters had the glitter.
Yeah. Probably like 30 minutes. Later, probably do it again. Like it only gets like.
I agree with that statement.
The skidding doesn't do anything. Just wear a helmet.
Hi.
Welcome to Brew Life Modern.
There's brews.
And we life. And then we modern.
Modernize it. Package it, sell it, put it on the moon.
Brand it, boom.
That's good. Sheila, I want you to take this down. You see that? Right there? That's wart. We're gonna put it on the moon, okay? Before you know it.
And it's time for the outro.
So, as you can see, it's nighttime.
Nighttime!
Because, you know, wintertime and COVID time, you know, COVID makes everything turn dark quicker. Darkness!
We even use the darkness yeast just for the time.
Yeah, exactly. We're in mid-December. And yes, all the darkness. Anyways, so we're ending up the brew day, right? Or we already ended up the brew day. Kind of cleaning up right now. Pitch the yeast. So in the ending of our brew day, we came out to about a smidge over 4 gallons. So we added like about half a gallon to get it up to 4.5.
Yep.
And cooled it down and all that stuff going on. Took some gravity readings, important gravity readings. Make sure to get those.
Yes.
And not,
if I had a nickel.
Yeah, if I had a dollar for every gravity ring I didn't take, I'd probably have like 30 bucks right now.
You'd probably be a lot more drunk.
Yeah, that too. More beer to earn. But piss yeast, and now we're just waiting for it to ferment. Should be a delicious beer. We tasted the wort. It was cooled down.
It was good. I like it. A little bit of smoke. Some of that smoke from the peated malt that we added was coming through, and that's like a campfire kind of smoke, which is good stuff. You'll find a lot of peated, Scotch whiskeys where they add that peat moss from the smoked grain, and so just a hint of that, really, really hint. We'll see how it comes after fermentation, but Nate's gonna be smoking the coconut. So that'll add a little bit of more smoke to it, and we can really kind of divvy it up during secondary.
Yeah, so today is Saturday. So
hopefully,
one of the days. I mean, is it not still March? Are we not still in lockdown for COVID? I don't know. Anyways, yeah, so next Saturday, I'm going to be smoking about a pound of shredded coconut, organic coconut. In like a Traeger system, probably smoke it with like cherry wood.
Ooh.
Wood,
cherry wood, wood.
Yeah.
How much cherry wood? A wood, cherry wood. It's just
me. Five.
I like it.
So doing that, that also helped give a little bit more smokiness to our beer or a stout. So we're gonna be, we're doing that. Next Saturday, a week after, and let it ferment for another week, and then if, take gravity rings between here and there, because, you're adding more sugar to it as well, so you want to make sure it's fermented fully before bottling, obviously.
We will do that. It'll be a little bit of a wait, but it'll be a good turnout.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be full of coconut, full of chocolate malt flavor, a little bit of smoke. That's our desire. Not the sweetest stout you've ever had. Not the most coconutty stout, but we're looking for balance here. A little bit of smoke, a little bit of coconut, balance.
Yep. All right, so we're at my work. I'm going to be smoking the... got about 2 pounds of... 1.5 pounds of coconut, and also smoking 5 pounds of honey. Traeger system at about 165, 170 for about an hour. And then after that, it should be ready to go. I'm gonna be pouring the honey once it's done back in its container. It's easier to transport. And then I have a bag to put the coconut in. Essentially roasting it, or not smoking it, to get a little bit more of the smoky flavor and toasty, smoky coconut. It's delicious, and it's gonna add more body to the stout as well. And then for the honey, that's gonna be used in another video. Once we bottle up the stout, gonna be making a higher gravity mead. Gonna have a little bit of smokiness to it. So stay tuned for that video. But right now, it's actually just waiting and waiting for an hour.
It'll be good, right, bro?
It will be good.
All right.
Cheers to that.
Cheers to that.
So thanks for watching the video. We'll try to have more video content out, but
it's weird with COVID and lockdowns. And
it's Christmas time, everyone. So Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, everything involved. We love you.
And we'll see you next video.
Cheers.
Cheers.